Warhammer 40,000 Apocalypse is very simply a mass battle game set in the 41st millennium, where you're going to take command of vast armies across wonderful battlescapes, roll lots of dice, have loads of fun.
It's built on the Warhammer 40,000 game system, so if you're familiar with that, you'll pick up Apocalypse really quickly. But what we wanted to really represent was that much bigger scale. So it plays in a different way, it's got its own rule system. That was trying to represent some of those really big weapons and the really big effects that can happen in a Warhammer 40k Apocalypse game.
But the whole game has been designed to be quicker, faster, and more suited to the scale of battle you're doing.
We really wanted to shrink the amount of time that you needed to play the game. And there's less time when you're doing nothing other than watching your opponent move and roll dice. So we've made the game work in a kind of much more alternating way. The last thing we wanted to do was make sure you always got to use your favorite models throughout the game. So one of the things that can happen is you set up your new knight and your opponent is terrified by it and shoots his entire army at it, and you remove it from the board before it does something. In this version of Apocalypse, you always do damage at the end of the turn, and that enables you to always get to use whatever models you'd like.
So even if you get 100 blast markers on a unit, it's still going to get to do something before you actually resolve the effects of what that damage are. As part of Warhammer 40,000 Apocalypse, we've written a data card for every single unit in the 41st millennium. So all the units that you're currently using in 140,000, you can use in 140,000 Apocalypse.
What we wanted to make sure is that we still captured the kind of flavor of the different armies and the different factions within those armies. And a lot of the way that we've done that is through using the command asset cards.
Command assets are essentially tactical ploys, sneaky tricks, resources that are at your disposal to unleash apocalyptic hell upon your opponent.
They enable you to do things like declare the power of the war or cast a psychic power that are suitably apocalyptic. They also give you something to plot and plan with whilst your opponent's doing his turn. So one of the things we wanted to do to make sure that Apocalypse was easily accessible if you've played Warhammer 40,000 before is that your armies are organised in a very similar way. So they use detachments. Those detachments are straight analogues of the ones from Warhammer 40k. So you can literally just take your 40k army and play Apocalypse with it using the same detachments. What we've found is over time, people start to tweak those detachments in an Apocalypse game to kind of make each detachment have a particular role. When you play a game of Apocalypse, the thing that you activate each turn is a detachment. So we like to think of it that in Kill Team, you play with individual models. In Warhammer 40k, is a game about units. And Apocalypse is a game about detachments. So each turn, you activate a detachment, then your opponent activates the detachment. And during that, you move, shoot, fight with it, do all of the things that that detachment does.
As part of Apocalypse, we've included a mission generator. That mission generator is inspired very much by the Open War mission generator that we have for Warhammer 40,000. The idea will be, very simply, there are tables that you can roll on to determine what kind of map you should be, what kind of twists you should have, what your mission objective would be, and a host of other kind of things. So you can either pick or choose any combination of mission. You'll never run out of Apocalypse missions to play.
We really wanted to make sure that it was different if you were fighting your apocalyptic battle in a desert or a warp storm. So we've created a whole range of different warzone effects that again mean that even if you do happen to roll the same mission twice, it still plays differently if it's in a different warzone.
My current Apocalypse army are my Howling Griffins. It's my largest force. It's perfect for Apocalypse. But I should probably broaden that out and go, actually, it's probably my Imperium army. I can add to that my Knights, my Sisters of Battle, my Imperial Guard. It all goes into one giant Imperium army.
I've got a couple of armies, actually. One of them was lucky enough to be in the book, which was my Goth Orcs. Which are the kind of arch nemesis of Robin's Howling Griffin Marines. So it was really good fun to be able to fight some really big battles against those. And then I'm also working currently on a Space Marine army of my own, which is just about at apocalyptic levels now. So we're a couple more units and I'll be able to play some proper Apocalypse games with it.
Playtesting Apocalypse was a huge amount of fun, mostly just because all the games just look so fantastic. It was really good as well to kind of go up against some armies that I hadn't played against in a lot, mostly just because all the stews orcs.
My orcs saw a lot of battle, which was great. And there were some great moments. One of them was I got to use my Stomper, which I don't get to use that often in games of 40k itself. Being an orc and a goth orc at that, it tends to just rush across the battlefield, try and kill loads of stuff. Hopefully, if it dies, it explodes and takes things out with it.
Whenever a Stomper or a Knight blows up, it's always entertaining. It's always very satisfying. I think one of my favorite things was a game we had just the other day where my chapter master and Gazgul duked off and annihilated each other. But it was very heroic. It was very apocalyptic. It was just what you wanted.
Normally when I play Robin, I lose. I'd like to think that really eventually I'll get him, but so far unlucky.
Apocalypse, when it's laid out on the battlefield, is nothing less than a spectacle. It's all the toy soldiers arrayed in kind of like either serried ranks or in kind of massed hordes, filled with tanks, commanders leading them, moving in whole detachments. It looks fantastic.